Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to perform clean boot in Windows 11 operating system in order to troubleshoot different issues in the clean boot environment. So what is clean boot actually? Here is the clean boot overview. A clean boot starts Windows with a minimum set of drivers and startup programs so that you can determine whether a background program is interfering with your game or program. Basically, you can identify a culprit program that creates issues on your system using the clean boot process. And here is how you can perform a clean boot in Windows 11 operating system. We will start with the search box. Click on the search box and type msconfig, and from the search result select system configuration, and for this app make sure you select run as administrator. In case if you are not administrator of your system, you need to sign into administrative account to launch this utility and perform the clean boot operation. Now in the system configuration window, switch to the services tab. It is the third tab here, services tab, and on this tab all the services are listed for your operating system. So carefully first check hide all Microsoft services, because Microsoft services are essential services for your system. We will first hide all of them so that we cannot accidentally turn them off. So we have already hidden the Microsoft services, all Microsoft services. Now we have here remaining the third party services, and in case if you are facing issue with a third party program, one of these services may be a culprit or the root cause. So what you need to do is, currently for performing the clean boot operation, we will disable all of them and check if the issue persists after disabling all of third party services. So simply hit the disable all button here, and all of these services are now turned off or disabled, or some of them may be disabled after a reboot. Then click apply, and then we will go to startup tab, then click open task manager. Now in the task manager window, this opens the startup apps, and here you need to make sure that the all of these startup items are set to disabled state. So in this case, I can spot some enabled startup items. Just select them and click disable, and they are now all disabled here. Now it's time to reboot the system. For this, we will right click on the start button and select restart. After this, the system will be restarted, and when it reboots, it will be rebooted in the clean boot environment. So just log in to your system as usual. There is nothing different. Just a clean boot environment is there, which prevents or has restricted all the third party program services. Now we will again open msconfig using the search feature. Again go to services tab. Here again hide all Microsoft services, and here you can see that all of the third party services are stopped as we disabled them earlier, and we are in the clean boot environment. Now in order to identify the culprit program or its service, you have to enable these services one by one and then restart your system and check if the issue occurs. By the end of all of these services checking, you will be find the service which could cause issue on your system. And once you identify the culprit third party program or the service, you can simply troubleshoot it by uninstalling it or updating it or reinstalling it, and that should fix the issue on your system. So in this way, the clean boot helps you to identify a program or service that could cause trouble on your system and helps you to specifically locate it so that you can resolve the issue on your system. Now, how to go back to the normal mode without clean boot environment. So let's see how you can go back to the normal mode. So we have to revert the changes. We have to enable all the services like the third party services we disabled earlier. So just select all of them and then click enable all, and also enable the startup items we disabled in order to go to the clean boot. So again, go to startup apps of task manager and select disabled items and then click enable. And once you enable all of these things, you can simply restart your system and you will be again booting into the normal mode. So that's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.